Good morning, everyone. My name is Drew.
My name is Milanis.
And my name is Justin.
And we're your MCs for today. For today's all-school morning meeting, the Black Student Union will be putting on a fashion show. As you can see, Lucy was being very unoriginal when she thought of this idea. So shout out to Indian Club for doing it first. Hey, ADC fashion show next? Anyways, in honor of Black History Month, the BSU wanted to acknowledge how Black culture has influenced many fashion trends throughout history. From logo mania to nameplate necklaces to sneaker culture, the list is endless. We also must remember that the fashion industry is largely built on the subjugation of Black and brown bodies established by structural racism. This is why it is so important to recognize the inequities of the acceptance of Black style and culture and to support POCs who have been marginalized, misrepresented, or stereotyped by the fashion world. With that being said, we hope that this presentation serves as an acknowledgement of Black history and its monumental influence on today's fashion. We hope you enjoy it.
Well, then, are y'all ready to get this show on the road? Okay.
I'm ready. How about you, Drew?
Whoa, wait a minute. I think we should address the style on this stage.
What? Cue the music.
Yeah, B. Talk your shit. How you going, Brady? It's tied at number one.
All right. Starting off the Atlantic, please welcome Nigerian princesses Lucy, Tony, and Kiki. These three girls are representing two tribes today, Igbo tribe and Yoruba tribe. Kiki and Tony are wearing traditional outfits worn by Yoruba women in the southwest of Nigeria called Iro and Boba. This headgear is called Gila and is often a statement piece. Give it up for our beautiful ladies.
We're not out of Africa just yet. Welcome Fadila and Aaliyah, stunting in some Ethiopian attire. There you go. Fadila looks beautiful in her traditional coffee dress. Coffee is a big part of Ethiopian culture and is often used during various ceremonies. Aaliyah is wearing another traditional Ethiopian dress, usually worn to church and festive events. Give it up.
We're sailing back across the Atlantic and heading to the Caribbean. Put your hands together for Miss Peyton Fisher. Peyton is wearing a bandana dress, considered the national costume of Jamaica. Today, the use of bandana plaid is largely ceremonial and symbolic. The most visible use of the bandana is the costuming of singers and storytellers. It's also worn on Jamaican Heritage Days and other special cultural occasions.
What's that? Is that the sound of saxophones and trumpets? Looks like we're in Harlem now. Miss O'Keddy is dressed in her Bessie Smith, who is known for her powerful voice, confident personality, and her large feather hat. During the era of the Harlem Renaissance, jazz became popularized by African Americans in New York City. And so, Black culture and fashion became widespread. Give it up for Miss O'Keddy!
We're still in America, but now we're jumping all the way to the 60s. Give it up for Yasmina, Miss Wilkerson, and Elijah sporting some seriously sick fits.
Whoop, 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 whoop!
The 60s marked a shift in Black culture away from mainstream white standards of beauty. Yeah. This is the period that brought back the big, bold, and beautiful afros that we often see today to represent Black empowerment.
Wow. If you look behind me, you'll see two real-life Black Panthers, Miss Edwards and Miss Prince. The Black Panther Party was a Black Power political organization founded in 1966. The Black Panthers were known for their standard uniform, all black everything. Black leather jackets, black pants, a black beret, and a fist in the air.
Whoa, guys, where did you get these bodacious outfits from? LJ and Trey are wearing dashikis!
Yeah, LJ. Yeah, Trey.
Woo!
Yeah.
colorful shirts commonly worn by Tanzania and Kenya and Somalia. Dashikis emerged in the U.S. market during the late 60s as symbolism for Black American Afrocentric identity during the Civil Rights Movement and the Black Power Movement.
Oh, looks like we're in the 80s now. Here's Reagan, Shekinah, and Erica. Black fashion in the 80s was full of psychedelic print shirts, oversized garments, voluminous hair, and acid-washed denim. Shekinah's outfit is inspired by Lisa Landry from Sister Sister, and her hair is inspired by Janet Jackson. Regan is wearing bright colors and acid wash, showcasing the colorful aspect of the decade. Erica is wearing a jersey.
Here comes the 90s, heavily inspired by hip-hop culture. Oversized tees, Tims, dungarees, and denim dominated the fashion world.
Give it up, give it up!
Yeah, here we got your home reenacting an iconic fit by Dwayne The Rock Johnson. And Josh is wearing a staple of 90s attire, a tracksuit with a Kango hat. More specifically, this tracksuit is from Aniche and was made in 1996 here on the East Coast in New York City.
For our next duo, you all know them, we all love them, Zach and Chase. These two are showing love to one of Will Smith's iconic movies, Men in Black. Give it up, give it up. Will Smith has made great strides for the Black community in entertainment.
Does this era even need an introduction? Tiana, Zayla, and Alyssa are here to bring in the era of Y2K. From iconic artists like Destiny's Child and other African-American pop artists of the 2000s, the year Y2K is one of the most exuberant in terms of fashion. Most people point to Britney Spears or Paris Hilton for popularizing this style, but actually hip-hop artists such as Missy Elliott and Salt-N-Pepa already wore athletic clothing as fashion statements.
All right, everybody, come out and take a bow.
Let's give it up for all of our artists.